In this video, I'll show you how to build a model that's as simple as possible, yet capable of flying very well. It's a flying wing type model. I chose 6mm thick styrofoam for the model's body. It's a lightweight and flexible material. Some reinforcement is needed to reduce the flexibility, create a more robust and durable model. For this purpose, I'll be using 3mm kraft foam board for some parts of the body. The wing will be flat. I won't be using any airfoil designs. My goal is to build a very simple model. I want it to be easy for anyone to build quickly. I recommend using a new utility knife for cutting. A worn blade won't produce clean lines. In some cases, two passes may be necessary for a cleaner cut. There are special adhesives for styrofoam, such as Uhu Pour, but I prefer a general purpose adhesive. It can bond different types of materials to styrofoam when needed. This adhesive isn't fast. I want to continue building without waiting for it to fully harden. That's why I use paper tape for support. The control surfaces must have sufficient and smooth movement. To achieve this, the wing facing edge must be cut at approximately a 45-degree angle. I'll be using fiber tape for the hinge connection. Fiber tape has both strong adhesion and flexibility. For aircraft constructed with foam or similar materials, it can always be used for this purpose. Any micro servo is suitable for the controls. I chose the MG90S servos because they are inexpensive. They are sufficient for this model. Alternatively, you can choose the much cheaper blue SG90 servos. Fiber tape has a reinforced structure with fiber threads. This structure makes it very strong. That's why I use it to reinforce both the top and bottom of the wing. There's no need to completely cover the wing. 3 or 4 rows at the top and bottom will suffice. Any more would add unnecessary weight. Thank you. I'll be attaching kraft foam board to the bottom of the wing for support. This will prevent the wings from flexing too much. The inside of this material is styrofoam. The outside surfaces are covered with kraft paper. It's a much more rigid material than regular styrofoam. I designed an Arduino-based remote control for this model. The Gerber files and code are linked below the video. I received the PCB manufacturing service for the transmitter and receiver circuits from JLCPCB. JLCPCB provides easy, affordable, and reliable PCB and PCBA solutions, empowering electronics engineers to develop projects efficiently. One of the reasons I choose JLCPCB is its user-friendly web interface, which allows for very easy ordering. You can easily upload your Gerber files. Once uploaded, you can specify the desired features for your PCB. There are many options available, including layer count, material type, and PCB color. Once you've made your selections, you'll instantly see a price quote. Finally, you can place your order using secure payment methods. Your PCBs will be ready in as little as 24 hours. Your order will be delivered to you as quickly as possible through leading logistics companies like DHL or FedEx. And now let's place the electronic components on the PCB and solder them. A motor mount is required to mount the motor to the fuselage. I made the motor mount from regular cardboard. I coated the surfaces of the cardboard with instant adhesive, stiffening and strengthening the cardboard. I'll use 4 3-millimeter screws to mount the motor. Then, I'll glue the motor mount to the fuselage.
I will be using a 2205 size, 2300 kV drone motor. A 5x5 or 5x4.5 3-blade propeller can be preferred for this motor.
This RC circuit I designed has 6 channels. However, we will only use 3 for this model, as 3 channels are sufficient for flying wing models. In the receiver circuit, the 2nd and 4th channels have a mixing function. This allows 2 servos to control both the elevator and aileron simultaneously. The 3rd channel is for the ESC. Motor speed is controlled by the 3rd channel. These types of models don't have a vertical stabilizer attached to the tail. Vertical stabilizer pieces must be attached to the wingtips to ensure stable flight. I used a 3S battery for the model. Its capacity is 1,800 milliamp hours. This battery is ideal for the center of gravity. However, you can also choose a 2,200 milliamp hour battery. A small 2S is sufficient for the transmitter.
Benzinden bir, denedim.